Hi everyone, my name is Aliana Ortiz and I'm Pre-Health Academic Advisor in the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences, and this is the Pre-Health 101 presentation. Our agenda for today is going to be an introduction to pre-health resources at UF, academic expectations, career exploration, extracurricular activities, and next steps you can take following this presentation. Pre-health advising at UF. Many of us are located in the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences in the Academic Advising Center, otherwise known as Ferrier Hall on campus. Pre-health advising appointments are offered in person and Zoom Monday through Friday. And during peak times, such as drop ad or advanced registration, we can book up pretty early, so it's important to know you may need to plan ahead. Here you can click this link or scan the QR code to meet the UF Pre-Health Advising team. Pre-health resources at UF. We offer one-on-one advising both in person and remote. Sometimes group advising via drop-in Zooms are offered. We also offer pre-health workshops. This can be a workshop on whether or not to drop a course, to application preparation, or to knowing how to pick your professional school and everything in between. We also offer pre-health courses here in the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences, such as Introduction to the Health Professions. Additionally, we offer mock interviews and personal statement reviews. Mock interviews will be held with the pre-health advisor, whereas personal statement reviews are also held with pre-health advisors to review a final draft of your personal statement prior to applying. So our UF pre-health advising website, here you can see a screenshot of the homepage. And on this page, you can view about our advising services. Here in the screenshot, you can see that UF utilizes a flipped advising model. This means we encourage students to complete prior research on their desired health profession before booking an appointment. This is able to help students in being able to be better prepared and gather the information independently, and therefore be able to bring higher level questions and concerns to the pre-health advisor. On the website, we also offer health career exploration. So this means that if you scroll down on our homepage, you can see many different tiles of different health professions. We also offer information about extracurricular activities. We offer academic semester plans for each pre-health pathway, application prep and information, profession-specific details, and there are also many other additional resources that will prove to be beneficial on your pre-health journey here at UF. So first, let's talk about academic preparation. I want to first start off by saying any major is great. When you're thinking about what major to choose, you should choose something that you're genuinely interested in studying. Your major, you'll be taking those courses for 4 years while you're here at UF. So you definitely want to make sure it's something you have an interest in, because this is what's going to take up the majority of your time in your college career. It's great to learn about sciences, but it's also important to learn about people through foreign language, anthropology, psychology, and sociology courses. It's important to note that professional programs are looking for well-rounded and diversely educated students. So perhaps maybe picking a major that's not a science major could be very beneficial for you and help make you that well-rounded student. Moving on is our prerequisite chart. So across the top of this prerequisite chart, you can see all of the different pre-health professions in which we advise for. And if you use this link or click the QR code, you can get this prerequisite chart for your own keeping. Anything that has an X will be a required course. For example, if we look in the medical column, the chemistry courses, chemistry one, chemistry two, organic chemistry one, organic chemistry two, and biochemistry all have X's, along with biology one, biology two, physics one, and physics two. Anything that may have an R, for example, in the medical column, we can see that genetics and microbiology have an R. This means that we highly recommend you take these courses prior to applying. It's important to note as well that psychology and sociology, along with statistics, are required, but these are also content that is on your MCAT. So this is definitely important that you're familiar with those courses and are prioritizing taking those courses. Here you can see a model semester plan, and we offer these for many of the different health professions. You can scan this QR code or visit the website to get to it. But here we have a model semester plan for a pre-med student. So basically what this plan will do is break down each of your prereqs and when you should be taking them. And it will also tell you when you take the MCAT and when you might apply. And if you take in the MCAT or applying in a certain summer denotes a gap year or does not denote a gap year. This is a great resource to use when you're building your four-year plan prior to coming into visiting a pre-health advisor. So when it comes to incoming credit, that could be AP, IB, ACE credit. We recommend that if you're coming in with that credit for prerequisite courses, that you repeat that course or you take a higher level course in that content area. So policies can vary by the school, so it's definitely important that you research the schools in which you plan to apply to, but it's important to note that many professional schools will not take incoming credit for their prereqs. So that being said, if you come in with AP credit for Bio 1 and Bio 2, some medical schools, dental schools, PA schools, whatever it may be, they might not take that AP credit as part of the prereqs, which means you'll be missing Bio 1 and Bio 2 prereqs. Things to consider when you're trying to decide if you should repeat or take a higher level course. Do you want to review? So maybe you have credit for Chem 1, but you took it your sophomore year of high school. Are you really going to be prepared to take the MCAT in your third or fourth year in college? Do you want to be able to apply anywhere? Like I said, policies vary by school. So if you don't repeat or take a higher level course, you may be inhibiting yourself on what schools you can apply to. Are you prepared for the standardized tests, the MCAT, the DAT, the GRE? And are you prepared for the upper level courses? AP credit for Chem 1, that might not prepare you for Chem 2 at the UF level. When it comes to semester loads, so for your first semester at UF, we recommend 12 to 15 credit hours. Every semester thereafter, we recommend 15 to 18 credit hours. And when you're building your semester course load, here are some things you want to consider. You want two science or math courses. You want to have major specific courses. And when you're in your first few years here at UF, you want to consider general education courses. And then additionally, you have any minor courses if you're pursuing a minor, and then you have your elective courses. And if you visit the pre-health website, we have a document on that website with a list of pre-health elective courses, which could be beneficial when you're building your schedule. Moving on to electives. So some important questions to consider when it comes to electives are, what do you know about people who are different from you? What do you know about sociological influences on health? And how can you develop professional skills? As I said, when talking about major, professional schools want to see a well-rounded student. So that means they want to see more than just your core science prerequisite courses. They want to see that you're taking courses that teach you how to interact with people, how to be culturally aware, and how to develop those professional skills. For example, maybe you don't feel confident in your public speaking skills. That being said, you could take an elective in public speaking and really grow those professional skills. Additionally, focusing on people-focused courses. For example, anthropology, psychology, sociology. These are all courses that teach you about human interaction in different facets of that. When we're looking at applying, we want to think of holistic preparation. So on this image here, you can see the applicant, which would be you in the middle circle, surrounded by smaller circles. And those are all areas that make up your application. So we have, as we know, academics and entrance exams. We have clinical volunteering, shadowing, research, non-medical community service, and other competencies, which these competencies will vary by profession. So first, I want to talk about cultural competency. This is really important because medical schools, dental schools, PA schools, whatever professional school, they want to see that you're culturally competent, that you're aware that you may have a diverse patient population with different religions, ethnicities, socioeconomic classes, and they want to know that you're able to respect that and know that you know how to interact with those different individuals. When it comes to elective, taking electives that build your cultural competency are a great way to show that you are proficient in this area. Moving on to clinical volunteering or employment. We first want to make sure that your clinical volunteering and or employment is consistent and constant. So this means that you didn't just do clinical volunteering one summer of your entire time here at UF. We want to make sure that you're doing it over the entire span that you're here. We also want to make sure that it's meaningful and that you're having good patient contact. So you might volunteer at Shands, but if you don't have patient contact and aren't doing something meaningful, it doesn't really matter when it comes time to apply. When it comes to employment, you might want to consider getting a certification. That could be a certified nursing assistant, an EMT, a medical assistant. This is a great way to get good hands-on patient experience while also getting paid to do so. Shadowing. So shadowing is a little different in clinical experience. Shadowing, you're going to be watching a physician, a dentist, a PA, a physical therapist, whatever it may be, you'll be watching them. You want to watch physicians, dentists, so on, in different settings and different specialties. So maybe in your professional pathway, you know you want to work in peds. That's okay. Shadow a pediatric. But you also want to shadow in different areas so that you can show that you've thoroughly explored that profession. And when it comes to shadowing and observation, you want to make sure that you're keeping track of your hours and that you also have contact information for those who you have shadowed. When it comes time to apply to your professional schools, you may need to verify those shadowing or observation hours. So maintaining contact with the individuals that you did that with will help that process go along smoothly. Research. So research is highly valued, but it's not required. And the level to which you need research can also greatly vary depending on your professional pathway. Research is important because these professional schools want you to understand the process and the application of research. But it's also important to note that you can get involved in research in any field. Research doesn't have to be just what you see in this picture. It doesn't have to be beakers and syringes and pipettes. You can do research in many different areas, in the social sciences, in human behavior, and human interaction. So really, when you're looking for research, you want to find something that interests you and that you'll be genuinely excited to research about. Community service. This one is really important, and it's important that as a student here at UF, that you are getting involved in community service outside of the pre-health or medical pathways. When you're thinking about what community service to get involved with, some things you can think about are, what are some issues that are important to you? Do you have specific populations you're drawn to? Do you have certain hobbies? So maybe you dance or you sing or you're a painter. Using those hobbies is a great way to volunteer in the local community. And it's important to also note that while maybe going to your hometown in the summer and volunteering is great, we also want to see that you're volunteering here in Gainesville, in the community that you're living in the majority of the year while you're working towards your degree at UF. And when you're doing your community service, ask yourselves questions. And after you finish, make sure you reflect and see how that helped you and overall what you learned from that experience. Leadership resources. So leadership can look different, and there's many different ways that you can gain leadership positions. So that could be through employment, student organizations, UF. If you visit their student activities and involvement website, you can see all of the organizations we have here on campus. I really encourage you to get involved in student organizations while you're here. And that doesn't just have to be pre-health organizations. Get involved in an organization just because you have an interest in it. Another great way to show leadership is through TAing or being a teaching assistant. This is a great way to not only get leadership experience, but show mastery in a certain course. We also offer many ambassador programs on campus. So potentially through your college, you can be a College of Liberal Arts and Sciences ambassador, College of Health and Human Performance ambassador. And this just means that you are representing your college and you may attend events for incoming students, prospective students, and things like that. And you get to just share your experience in why you chose UF and what UF has to offer and why it's such a great institution. Some other leadership resources could be a preview staffer, a first year Florida peer leader, or a camp counselor. So moving on to our next steps after this presentation, I highly encourage you all to enroll in the Pre-Health Essentials Canvas course. You can find the link to that on our UF Pre-Health website, which is located right here. I also encourage you to join the PreHealth email listserv and follow the PreHealth Buzz blog. So the listserv will send you emails about different PreHealth opportunities that we have here at UF. It will also share information about the UF specific professional programs. So UF College of Medicine, UF College of Dentistry, UF's PT, OT program, UF's PA school, things like that. And then the PreHealth Buzz blog is where we post many different pre-health resources that are offered outside of UF. And then finally, I encourage you to create your pre-health action plan. So similar to that model semester plan that I showed you in using the prerequisite chart, you will kind of build out what your academic plan will look like for your time here at UF. That can include your major courses, your electives, any potential minors you may have in your professional prerequisite courses. I definitely encourage you to explore that website, build that pre-health action plan, and then come in and see a pre-health advisor for an appointment. Thank you.